I never figured out what landing gear was. Shit. Okay. Let's stop and figure out what landing gear is. Controls. Targeting, weapons, cooling. Seriously, landing gear is fucking unbound? Wow. Okay. I want something that... What do I want for landing gear? Can we do pinky switch? No, I don't want a pinky switch. Let's do that button for landing gear, okay. It was set to deploy heatsink before. Okay, what about... secondary fire. Okay. Well, what about... Oh, you weren't used for anything. That's a shitty place to find that, but... It'll do for now. Let's go... Since I canceled purposely. Let's go and bind it there, and then I don't have to worry about figuring out where it is. Too far. Landing gear. Okay. Now I can undo my landing gear. Zoom. All right. Let's see if we can do this. Now we're talking. Give me power to engines. There we go. I don't know what my engine boost is. Aw, yeah. Now we're talking. Check that out. Fascinating. Okay. Well, let's take a look here. Where is the station? Station is that away. Let's slow it down. Far away is the station. Oh, far away is the station.
Assist on.
You fucking kidding me? Okay, I'm not close enough. Request docking. go this way. Yaw's coming tomorrow. I get my pebbles.
Warning, landing gear not deployed.
Welcome.
On top of which, if you are looking at my stream, which I doubt you are, but you know, hey, anything's possible, you will see that I'm wearing my Oculus right now, and in my lower right hand, corner of my right eye, it's very dark. It's very dark. Dark and scary place. Hurts. Hurts to watch. Okay. Head look. And that is to adjust the power settings. That. That's my landing gear. I really think it's that button, but it doesn't appear to be close to this button. Doing this without locking these targets. But you know what? Let's get some fight practice instead. Too. Center button is. It's see the attraction in this. Thrust does help us, so here's a return. Thank you. hasn't found anything. Let's see what happens. Did I just assign that to the wrong one? Vertical thrust axis is what I wanted on that one. Yeah. I actually want vertical axis. No, I need one vertical axis. I have vertical axis already. Using it for yaw for now, since I don't have the pedals yet. Yaw axis. But we do need to give you a little bit of dead zone like that. Come on. Where are we at for my fibers? Okay, I'm gonna do a little bit of risky there. Let's equip that. Okay. Now, how do I cycle my fire groups? Not there. Okay. Oh, my hard points are out. How do I retract my hard points? It's gotta be one of these buttons. That's cargo scoop.
Cargo scoop retracted. Silent running. Shields offline. Donor signature restored.
Not any of those switches.
Flight assist off. Frame shift drive is still on the keyboard. That's weird. Okay. That's target.
That's three. That's four. Okay, so that's target ahead. Play hard points, joy 21. Huh. Okay. Thank you. Oh, okay. Alright. Give me just a second, because as you can see, it's... Why do you gotta be so anti-game? Game capture. There we go. Okay. Let's make you nice and big. But put you behind everything else. Okay. Okay. So as you can see, both eyes are rendering just fine right now. It does it everywhere except in the ship. So I'm actually going to go into... I'm not going to undock just because I'm still getting used to the HOTAS. But the station is really obvious. So let's just load that. Oh, they did fix that? That's interesting, though. So it used to be during this load screen here, like the right eye wouldn't render at all until like the very end. And so, it was irritating, but at least it's all black, so it wasn't, you know, standing out so much, right? But once we get into the station here, what happens when we get in the station here? There, yeah, look at that right eye right now. It is awful. I mean, if I close my left eye, you can't see jack inside the cockpit other than what lights are lit up, because the ambient light just is not being rendered at all. So if you got both eyes, like, you get this really weird conflicting picture, and it's trying to, you know, composite your image, and it's like half there and half black, but not half black, because, you know, a portion of it, all the HUD and everything lights up correctly in the other eye. It's just nothing else renders quite right. You can kind of see like the outline looking down. You can kind of see like the knee and everything. But yeah, it's weird. Have you, let me tab out really quickly so I can see what you're saying, because I haven't found a good chat program yet that'll dump the Twitch chat into the Rift. Oh, of course, as soon as I tab out, it gets awful. Yeah, it is, isn't it? It's pretty awful. Have you seen it from, I'm sure you've seen videos of people doing the, like head tracking in space. The Rift in space is pretty cool. I'll go back into the tutorial here. Like I said, I don't want to take the regular ship out while I'm still figuring out my HOTAS controls, but let me, put that back on. Discretion, sometimes the better part of valor. Yes, I'm sure I want to... Oh, wait, no, did I just... Shit, I just exited. God bless. That's what I get for trying to do this shit at 3:30 in the morning. Let me fire it back up again here. I can make the little one in the corner a little bit bigger if that helps. I just put it there so that you could kind of see that. Anyway. Play. Did you actually reload correctly for once? Oh my goodness.
No, you didn't. Awesome.
Yeah, it's an experience getting this going, let me tell you. Tutorials, target practice. It's because it lets you free fly a little bit, right? So I've got the Thrustmaster, the Warthog controls, joystick 5 is right here. There we go. Okay. So the thing about the Warthog from Thrustmaster is that the Warthog does not. The Warthog does not have a yaw control. You can't take the stick and kind of crank it like you can on some others. So you actually have to use pedals. Or some other mechanism of yawing. So the Warthog actually has dual throttle action, and I've separated the two throttles, and I'm using the second throttle as yaw at the moment, although my pedals should be here in the morning. Like I said, it's a brand new HOTAS setup, right? So, hilariously enough, let's pull that back here for now, a lot of the control mapping, so if, let's just pull this back for a second. If you look at the joystick in-game, a lot of what you do on there actually ends up mapping out to be the same thing. So like if I go adjust my power settings, you can see what I'm doing on the joystick to do that. They're repeating the action on the controller. Ditto for most all the other like look functions and everything else. So like if I wasn't using the Rift, this would be like look at the various different displays. I mean, I can just look at them, right? And so that mapping isn't doing anything at the moment. But they did take some care with how they were doing their 3D model mapping, which I think is really kind of neat. So let's goose it here a little bit. Let's get some power to the engines here. Thing about having the throttle control is it's so much easier than using a keyboard and mouse to slow down and accelerate again. So if you need to make a really tight turn, of course the downside to turning like that is of course that you lose a bunch of speed, so you end up sitting in the same spot. So not necessarily great for dogfighting, right? But you do have a bit more control over what you're doing. I was trying to use the keyboard for throttle up and throttle down, just in continuous, and it wasn't really super accurate or super precise. Now the cool thing about the head tracking is, you know, you don't have to use any of the buttons to look to the side. You can just, you know, look to the side. You can just look up. You can look at different angles that you don't get to see just using the set buttons to look in a given direction, right? So I actually spend more time kind of looking out in space, especially combat. Like I said, I've been playing with the keyboard and mouse up until now, and when dogfighting, I keep an eye. I'm normally sitting like about like this, looking forward, just so I can see kind of what's happening above me too, right? Let's pitch down. Bit. Don't need that much. Okay. So again, you can see, I mean, it does take the throttle a second to respond. You can see, I mean, it actuates very fast, pulling it back and forth. Now, the default key bindings, of which I'm using the majority of at the moment, the default key bindings are unidirectional throttle, so I have to, if I want to go in reverse, I actually have to throw a hat switch. And then when I throw the hat switch, the throttle works just in a 100% reverse throttle. And then I pull the hat switch back and go in the other direction. Asteroid fields are kind of interesting because they give you more. Play games, right? Here we go. Kind of where yaw would come in handy to correct that. I mean, just pitch and roll, right? Or roll and pitch. But scoot past him. Okay, one of these should be. Ugh, I don't know where it is. I gotta find the engine boost button. It's about somewhere. There we go. Let's come back. Space, nobody can hear you in the trash can. Okay, come on. Oh, right. Head tracking. So not only do you have to have it fairly far forward, where you're looking also determines what's being selected for lock target ahead of you. While using the keyboard and mouse, I just tended to kind of line it up more and stare straight ahead, but since I'm not looking straight ahead, let's go this way. Okay, come on. Come on. Right up. There you are. Okay. Come on. Okay, so where's the next one? Into anything. There we go. Oh, and if you're still watching, it's kind of hard to see now, but they do actually render, like, everything in the ship as I get my cable, headphone cable stuck here, and my Rift cable, but you got first aid kit, the hatch behind you, and if you lean back, you can see the back of the chair, kind of stare through your chest somehow, because everybody's missing the middle of their chest, right? Tab out. Pain in the eyes again. Take a look. Yeah, the back of the chair is pretty cool. Okay, let's get back in here again. Like I said, I just don't have any way to view the chat stream in the Rift at the moment, so if anybody has a solution, feel free to share it. Otherwise, I just gotta pop out every so often to check. People who are new to the stream, did I? I just got the HOTAS set up here, the Thrustmaster Warthog today, and just kind of getting used to playing with it and the Rift. New boss probably ain't gonna be thrilled at me again tomorrow. Made a comment about it today. Oh well. No, I think one's a perfectly reasonable time to show up at work. Let's try basic combat. Oh, the throttle's going already. Okay, where is our... There is our bad guy. Come on, fuck. There we go. Okay. And again, for those, because I see we're up on viewers a little bit, I don't have really much for good yaw control at the moment, which makes this a lot harder than it would be otherwise, right? Or at least a little bit harder than it would be otherwise. Come on. My control experience prior to getting the HOTAS set up was mouse and keyboard. I had roll and pitch on the mouse. So again, I'm kinda, that's familiar to me. But I also had pitch and thrust sideways and thrust up and down on the keyboard. And just trying to figure out how to remap all of my reflexes here so far. There you are. And this is, on you now, okay. Come on. Come on. It's just a matter of finding it. Wait a moment. Come on. Nope. Let's do it. Right amount of pressure to put on this controller joystick. very disorienting at first, coming from the cam control, right? Yeah, so the one thing about the mouse control that I was doing is it was much easier to pull it diagonal. A little less disorienting than this is.
What do you have to say?
Alright, now this time I'm shutting down for real. Thank you for checking me out tonight. When I get the pedals in, I will give this another shot. Alright, adios.